Hello everyone, thank you so much for joining another Ready to Ride Pilates for Water Ride session, where today we are going to be working on your hips, those really important joints and all their surrounding muscles that really help you have a nice stable seat. So let's get going without any further ado, and we're going to start off with the walking exercise just to get you nice and mobile. Before you even start with that though, just check you're all lined up, nice light head, shoulders back and down and relaxed and open, headlights to the front. A nice equal weight through your feet. So off we go. Opposite arms and legs on the go. Making sure that your breathing is nice and regular. Coming down right into the base of your lungs and not getting tense and breathing up nice and shallow instead through your shoulders. Just watch that your ribs are gently sinking down towards your pelvis and not coming up and following your arms. Make sure your headlights are to the front. And your pelvic floor is staying on floor three. Okay, we're going to bring your arms back down. You might want to have your hands onto your headlights just to give them something to do. We're going to open out and loosen out through your hip joints now. So you can take one leg up, out and down. Then bring the other leg up, out and down. As much as possible, you want to keep the rest of your body fairly still. You will have to move. You can't stay completely statuesque. But you want to keep your body as still as you can so you focus on moving through your hip and not anywhere else. Make those movements as big as you need to. You may well find that you're stiffer on one side, very normal. You want to try and even up that movement before you then start. Okay, good job. We're now going to do your roll down. So you go to the end of your mat and have your feet together with your knees nice and soft, hands on the front of your thighs, chin onto your chest. And you're going to slide your hands down, curling up nice and tight through your spine as you go. Pause the bottom for a breath in, and then breathe out. Slide your hands back up, tuck down with your pelvis, and then you're uncurling right up through to the top of your neck. And then again, chin into your chest. This time, focus on moving each vertebrae one at a time as best as you can, and it's easier said than done, right down through the middle of your spine. Your low back before your pelvis starts to join in. Another breath in at the bottom. And as you breathe out, slide your hands back up, tuck down with your pelvis, and then you're stacking your vertebrae through your low back, mid back between your shoulders and right up into your neck as you look to the front. And we're going to do one more. So again, chin into your chest. And once again, try to feel that you're moving every single vertebrae one at a time. And it really isn't that easy, so don't worry. Last thing to move is your pelvis. Another breath in, and then you're going to breathe out, bend your knees, and we're going down onto your side, and you're going to start off in the clam position. So you're going to be onto your side with your knees bent, feet lined up with your bottom. And you can go really whichever position you want to do. If you want to keep your feet on the floor, that's fine. If you want to keep your feet off the floor as well, absolutely fine. Whichever though, mouse hole under here needs to stay open, pelvic floor onto floor three, and your top hand onto your top headlight. And then you're going to be opening and closing that top knee. So it doesn't matter whether your feet are on the floor or off. Mouse hole stays open so that your spine stays straight. Top headlight stays still so that you're working your glutes. Make sure you keep breathing and keep your pelvic floor onto floor three. Okay, good job. One more of those, and then we're going to turn onto your back, and we're going to have a go back to your scissors exercise. And again, you can choose which version you do. You can do this with your feet on the floor, or you can do them from tabletop. Whichever one you do, I suggest hands onto your headlights so you've got feedback about what your headlights are up to. Nice and neutral tummy position. If you've got a spiky ball, you might want to pop that on for this exercise. Pelvic floor onto floor three. So if you're going from the floor, you're coming up to tabletop and back down with each leg. In turn, moving from the hips, not cheating and bending the knees. If you're going from tabletop, then you're going to do each leg in turn. Once again, moving from the hips and watching that you're not just bending the knees, because that is significantly easier. Watch that you keep breathing and that your ribs are gently sinking down towards your headlights and not doming upwards, because that's a good indication that you're actually starting to lose some of that stability through your middle. Okay, we're going to bring your feet back down. Then we're going to move on to doing your hip twist. So this is very similar, same startup, neutral tummy, pelvic floor and level headlights. If you're going from the floor, you're going to be rolling each leg out in turn.
This one, like the scissors that you just done, is one of my wine glass exercises. So that means that the leg that isn't moving, you want to imagine you've got a wine glass on it. If you want to see more of those, I put some on Instagram at the end of 2020, so you can always go and have a look and see what those look like in reality. If you're going from tabletop, you're taking the whole leg out. So it's not just the knee, it's the whole leg that is on the move. So the foot should be following through with the knee, but your headlights are still staying still. Tummy is still staying neutral. Ribs are down towards your pelvis, not creeping upwards towards the ceiling. Okay, one more with each leg. Okay, then feet down. And then we are going to combine those two exercises. So again, it doesn't matter which position you are in, you can still combine them. If you are going from the floor, one leg up to scissors, one knee out to hip twist, same thing the other way. If you're going from tabletop, one leg is coming down whilst one leg rolls out, and the same thing the other way. So again, you can work at whichever one feels right for you today. Only work within what you feel comfortable to do. Still using your hands for that feedback, keeping your headlights as still as you can. Good job. Do one more each way. And back down one at a time if your feet were up. Excellent job. Make sure your breathing is nice and regular. Check that your headlights are still level and that your ribs are sinking down towards your pelvis and not up towards the ceiling. We're going to finish off on your back by doing your shoulder bridge. So to start off with, arms onto the floor beside you. Check your feet and knees are still hip width apart and your pelvic floor is onto floor three. Then you are going to roll back so you imprint your low back into the floor. And then carry on, so you're peeling up each vertebrae one at a time until you get to the top of your bridge. Approximately a straight line from shoulders, hips to knees. Nice breath in at the top, and then as you come back down, you're laying each vertebrae back down onto your mat one at a time, heading for that imprint at the bottom. Now I'm going to move my feet a bit closer in because I was feeling a little bit like I might be heading into cramp territory. If your feet are too far out, you'll find that you might get a bit of hamstring cramp. So again, pelvic floor, roll back to imprint, peel up each vertebrae one at a time. If you want to think of your spine like a ring of pearls or a bicycle chain, that can be a really helpful. Breath in. And then you're going to come back down again. Each vertebrae one at a time. Okay, we're going to make this a bit harder now. So I'd like you to have your hands so they're pointing up to the ceiling, your hands above your shoulders. Once again, pelvic floor, then roll back to imprint and peel up each vertebrae one at a time. Another breath in at the top. And then as you come back down, it's every single vertebrae in turn as best as you can. Head for that imprint and then to neutral. And all the time you're doing this, you want your hands to stay as still and as soft as you possibly can. So what we're working on here now is having that nice controlled hip opening and closing, if you like. So thinking about sitting drop, canter kind of movement, but keeping nice, light, soft and level hands. And that's quite often where we will fall down as riders, is that you can do the one bit but not the other. You can have the nice, light, soft hands but not have that soft, supple movement coming from your hips. Or you can have the hip control, but that's because you're fixing with your hands. So here we are doing both at the same time. Okay, so we're going to come back down after this one and then bring your hands back down. And we're going to finish off this exercise by doing some hip dips. So once again, pelvic floor, imprint and roll up. But this time when you get to the top, you're going to stay there and drop each side of your pelvis in turn. And when I say drop, I do mean drop one side, the other side stays still. What you're not doing is twisting down the middle, which actually I find quite uncomfortable to do. You are just doing one side in turn. And this is really good to be able to do because it shows you can move freely through the whole of your hip and pelvis area. But it also means you can stabilize one hip independently of the other. This is really useful for your lateral work, for your good leg aids, really useful concept for your body to be able to do. One more with each side. And then once again, come back down each vertebrae one at a time through your imprint to finish.
Then we're going to go onto the other side and do your clam the other way. So spin yourself around, or you can turn the face away if you're happy with what you're doing. Starting off once again with your feet lined up with your bottom. And as before, you can have your feet on the floor, you can have them off the floor. It's entirely up to you, as long as your mouse hole is open. Pelvic floor is onto floor three. Top hand for feedback. And then you're opening and closing that top knee. Making sure the breathing stays regular, the mouse hole is open, the pelvic floor is onto floor three. So everything else is still, all that movement is coming from your hip, being powered by your glutes. Good job, we're going to do two more. Super. Okay, then bring yourselves up into sitting and then into kneeling. And we're going to do a hip flexor stretch. I am going to do this from the side so you can see the movement I'm doing a little bit better. So when we talk about hip flexor stretch, we're not trying to lengthen your hip flexors. What we're trying to do is make sure that we can use that muscle, take it through its whole range. It's just quite nice to do it at the end of this session when you've been working really hard. What we don't want you to do is to stop with slightly tired hip flexors and then just get a bit stuck in one position. So don't fall over like I was just trying to then. So you want to have one foot up in front, hands onto your headlights, and you're going to tilt your headlights up towards the ceiling. You should feel it tight down through here. And then you're going to gently keep that as you push your pelvis forwards. And then come back up. And then ease that tilt off. And again, tilt your headlights upwards. Take your headlights forwards. And ease back and down. We do one last one this way, so tilting your headlights upwards, pushing the pelvis forwards. Come back and ease off. I'm going to swap exactly the same thing the other way. So get your balance before you start. Hands onto your headlights, tilt them up. You should feel the stretch up in front of the other side, and keep that upwards tilt as you push your pelvis forwards. And come back up and down. Another one just like that, so headlights up. And push forwards, come back up, and relax off, and do one last one this way. So tilt upwards, keep the upwards tilt as you push forwards, and back off and down. Okay, so we're going to leave it there. That exercise is also really good for just making sure you've got fine control of your hips and your weight as you move your weight forwards and backwards. So thinking of your rising trot particularly, it's a really nice, useful little exercise to do, because sometimes it can highlight subtle differences that other exercises may not do. So I hope you found some of those exercises helpful. Some of them are quite hard. You may well find that you're much stronger or much more coordinated on one side. That's okay, just keep working at it. Thank you so much for joining me, and I hope I will see you again very soon. Take care and bye-bye.